Welcome Natasha Hamilton.
Hi. How are you?
Oh, you look
here.
Welcome. You look so good.
I just felt your belly button.
Oh. Can't imagine you going to the front door in your PJs with no makeup. You're too glamorous.
Oh, honestly, I've got the worst array of pyjamas.
Worst? Why?
They're really sad because for some reason I must just go for grey and I've got, like, really odd bits, like tops from years ago that are, like, crop tops, you know, letting it all hang out on the sofa, but...
Don't tell her that. She's so obsessed with her pyjamas. She won't even wear them if she can't find the matching top.
No, I won't. They have to be matching.
Well, that's just sick.
Oh, man of rubbish.
Well, you're a bit like Carol then, you see, so yeah. That's right. You've
as
got
long
a mate.
As the comfy, that'll do.
That's exactly. Yeah.
Well, listen, you're in the first blush of a new love, aren't you? You just got engaged?
Well
not just, been engaged.
Yeah, I've been
a
engaged
while.
For a while and I'm getting married in 2 weeks.
2 weeks?
2 weeks.
Thank you. Are you excited?
I'm really, really excited. A bit nervous, but I picked my dress up on Saturday.
And?
Oh, well, I can't wait. I'm like, I'm shaking just thinking about it, but I keep thinking, oh, will it fit? Will it fit, please?
Where are you getting married, or is that a secret? Roughly?
Up north.
In this, oh, in this country?
In this country.
Okay.
Well, it was Miami on the beach, then it was Tuscany. And then it was up north.
No.
There's no place like home.
What was your first date with this love of your life, then?
Well, it wasn't the posh, is it? It was a nightclub in Essex.
How did that happen?
Nothing wrong with that.
Well, friends kind of had a night on, and we kind of eyed each other up before, and I'd phoned a friend, and I was like, so is he going to be there? Well, I'm going to be there, you know, one of them. And then when he was there, I was like... I didn't really know what to do, but we had a laugh.
And how did he propose?
He took me away to a health spa for the weekend, and we had a meal booked, and I was just in the bath, like, pampering myself, and he said, can I show you a magic trick?
Oh!
I was like, go on, then.
Please, yeah! Come on!
And he tied this piece of string to my finger, and he said, you know I love you, don't you? I was like, yeah. And then he let go of the ring, and it fell down, the piece of string.
Oh,
this ring?
Yes, this ring.
Oh, wow. Did you cry?
I did. I was like, of course I'll marry you.
It's quite imaginative, though, isn't it?
It was
magic
really, really good.
String.
Yeah.
And
in the bath.
If you'd said no, what if the ring was already on then? You'd gone, no, actually, no.
That would have been
a nightmare.
If they shoved you under the water.
Yeah. You're probably not at the right stage of your relationship to ask, but we're talking about sex as a duty. This new therapist says that that's how women should think of it. What do you reckon?
I think in relationships there's give and take, because sometimes one does want it and one doesn't, you know, and you can't always be horny at the same time, you know what I mean?
No.
But if you're being forced into doing something constantly that you don't want to do, then I think you're in the wrong relationship.
But if you're with the, yeah, if you're with the right person, obviously, even if you don't feel like it, then that person should be able to make you feel like it within like a few minutes.
Yeah. Isn't that like a woman thing? It's like, no, I don't want to, and then there's the kiss on the neck, and you're like, oh, go on then.
If you're good at it. Yeah. So you understand you're opening a restaurant?
Yes, I am.
So tell us about why, for one.
With your future husband.
Yes.
So you're not just marrying him, you're going into business with
partners.
Him as well.
Oh,
wow.
Well, they say the best partnership's a husband and wife, apparently. Well, I think we will be.
Don't ask Sherry.
Yeah, we're opening, like, a deli restaurant in Liverpool in the Met Quarter called Hamilton's. Oh. And that opens next week. So the week before the wedding.
You're not going to do anything in this restaurant, I assume.
I'm not a qualified chef, but I'm a qualified food taster, I think. I like my food.
The Met Quarter's lovely as well, I've been
there. It's really nice.
You dragged your mother into the kitchen?
Yeah, my mum was a cook and she's involved, so it's a family business, and Riyadh's sister's involved, and...
So a big family
affair. It is, and then also at the same time we're opening a members bar in Liverpool called H.
Oh,
so it was all supposed to be opening a while ago, but it's been going back and going back. So we've got Hamilton's opening on the 15th. and then get married the week after.
Oh, God.
And then
busy
Gordon
girl.
Ramsay will be round to sort out the kitchen nightmares.
Yes. I'm hoping not. My mum will have everyone in line.
Yeah. But you haven't abandoned music, have you? You've got things going on in the new year.
Yeah, I've
single
been
album.
Yeah, I've been recording my album in the studio, just taking my time. It's a little bit of funky soul, a little bit dance-based. And I've had a song go to airplay all over Europe and the States, which is called Round and Round.
Fantastic.
And also, I got the opportunity to support Lionel Richie on his tour.
Didn't he personally ask for you?
Yeah, well, we heard he needed an act, and me and my manager sent him a demo. And normally you have to pay to get on a tour, and he heard it and loved it. Loved the style of music and just said, come and do it for us.
Wow.
Brilliant. So,
and I was and on the first night, he gave me a shout-out. He was like, wow, that was great. And I was like,
aww.
And I've got the best picture of me and him, like, proper cheesy hugging, like my dad going, yeah. But he's so lovely, he's really
And amazing. You've got a Cilla Black cover single coming out as well for this big project that's getting loads of Liverpudlian talent together. What's that called?
Yes, it's called The Number One Project. And basically, Liverpool is the city in the world that's had the most number one singles. So every artist, Liverpool artist who's had a number one is being invited to come and do this big gig and put together an album. But you have to sing somebody else's number one. And the only girls on it was Atomic Kitten, Mel C and Cilla Black. And so I've chosen You're My World, and me and the girls are doing Anyone Who Had a Heart.
Oh, well, best of luck with that. Best of luck
Thank
with the restaurant. Best of luck with the wedding, and lay off the cake. You've got a dress to get into on Saturday. Natasha Hamilton, everyone. That's it for today. We will see you tomorrow at 12:30. Bye.